primary purpose for education. They say it's help young people, close cooperation with parents and families to become active, responsible, open-minded members of society. I'm not sure if you agree to that. I think it's certainly up there, but I still think that personal development is another very important element. Now, then you will find the ideas on the table, what they done, how they want to achieve that, and I'm not going to read it out. What they perhaps is interesting to know that they want to generate a sense of belonging, and they also want to empower teachers. Now, what is the reaction of the parliament? It's a bit of a vague reaction. Oh, Parliament of Turin, sorry, sorry that it's even better, I said it's a bit vague, but it was the Council of Europe, so it was a bit of a more broader reaction. But also they have 2 points, where they say, for education. It's very important, they say, grant appropriate means and resources to schools and teachers to promote education for democratic citizenship and human rights, with special emphasis given to the education of marginalized and disadvantaged contexts, and promote intercultural dialogue and the Living Together model, including schools. So I think the very important thing is that they talk about the fact that there has to be some financial resources, because I noticed that the declaration has many good words. I just brought them together. They want promoting, ensuring, strengthening, combating, encouraging, empowering, enhancing, fostering, exploring, protecting, supporting, safeguarding.
Applause.
Good. It's a great opportunity for us to turn their goodwill into action. And yesterday, already a variety of issues were mentioned as possible ways of it. There was the question about 2 people mentioned that we have to stress peace education. We have to change the traditional paradigm of wars and politics. There was the suggestion to change curricula from the traditional chronological approach to the outcome-based learning, or developing critical and relevant questions to the past which help young people to understand the present and may help them to orientate for the future. Change the learning approaches to a far more focus on multi-perspectivity, active learning, critical thinking. Concentrate on the development of values without preaching them. Develop global citizenship, internationalization, and even the word European identity, or the word sense of belonging to Europe as nations. And I think that this morning, Anton de Baals gave us a good sort of balance here, that yes, if we want to deal with the European history, we have to look at this 2 elements of the historical injustice, which is really a big point at the moment in the European Union, where quite some countries coming from the former socialist background feel that their history is not enough integrated in the big questions of Europe. But at the same time, we see not only in the negative development, but also look very much in the development of democracy. So that would be an interesting way to perhaps contribute to this European sense of belonging, not as a promotion of identity, but certainly as a reflection on a history of a political system. And then, of course, there was really the plea to open up to multicultural classrooms, allowing respect for diversity. I think many of these issues are beautiful ideas, and we all feel that we adhere to and we work also quite often in that level. Now it's really how can we take these words, these good intentions, these good sort of wise advice we receive into action, how can we make concrete steps. And the good thing is, I mean, I'm in a lot of conferences where all talking about education, but the real practitioner has to be found in the audience. Everybody knows about what education should do, but rarely people in education themselves have the voice. And I think you have now the fantastic opportunities as experts on the field to say, okay, with our experience, with our ideas, we think that if we want to support this declaration, these are the ways forward.
So, thank you for preparing everything. Now, for the task. Every table will get a package. You don't see it in the back, but you can assume this is what I'm talking about. In that, in large letters, as fit as A4, is the singular statement for that table. In the pack is also included a form that's actually the property of the host to bring down the concrete things that come out. And because you need to know, as Joke said, what are these EU ministers actually wanting to do, you can also circulate a bit what was actually the preamble of the declaration, from where the statement is coming from. We haven't given you the full statement because we want that interactivity on different points of the statement. One final practical thing before we kick off. You don't have to think about the time. I can do that. But I would try to make some kind of Pavlovian reaction from you. So when you hear something like, that's not working, I don't know, we'll make a glass sound. So when you hear the form thing that is like a glass sound, you just quit your discussion and move on. And the host will can also keep the time, but it's important to that it goes to the subconscious. So we have a the host had the four questions, yeah? On the form. The first question is, you look at the statement and you discuss together what are the challenges for implementation of this declaration in history and citizenship education.
But there is also increased
nationalist feelings. That's what they mean. Because in most countries, history curriculums.
This is a problem.
Other policies, right? Conflict. Ideal situation, but it's not always the same.
Okay, so too much time to spend on rope learning, and I have no time for this.
The entire structure is.
But I think the first question or the first
skills all involve a high premium of time spent on this, and yet your working day is so, you know, go, 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 go. It's trying to build into a model of how schools are organised, you build in that the time factor. Because talk is, in a sense, can be cheap.
That's spitting against the wind then.
Yeah.
But using the time you've got better, I think, is really important.
It's time management. You've got to deconstruct this text. In fact, there's two completely different issues. There's dialogue incorporation. Secondly, the audience isn't children, it's education stakeholders. So the argument of dealing with dialogic teaching, that I'm seeing.
So existing national language or language and they do not speak or society in the internet.
like my students, I read the beginnings of the and the test of none of my students, they read on other people like that. So we live in like this.
But we are all different. That's what we've experienced here, that we are all very different. We do things differently, we have different backgrounds. So we can't make this as a possibility or something.
And we get 75% of them totally engaged, but the 25% they're lost. We don't get them involved. And they said, oh, I found history, and they go out and do extreme.
But the full question was, what are the challenges for implementation of the declaration in history and citizenship education? So I didn't say the rest. In maybe history and citizenship. So
maybe starting to appreciate what children are and appreciate at the moment. Maybe they can help more in the, for example, we are doing the that kind of project, cultural remembrance. And actually that's the biggest problem at the moment, because we are coming in the regions and the parts of the country that are totally divided because of several things, not just the war, but a lot of other issues.
The bureaucracy is not the European Union participation.
Already you have cake.
So you said that red after the year policy. I think the problem with the whole thing is that you said it's the same that you need to promote
and well, now you the problem and causing this are not fixed. So you sort of try to put something on top of it without fixing what and the challenge is maybe just having the grounding for this, making sure that everyone can read and write and have the fundamentals in order. And it
wasn't it just what Anthony said that we also could do, because we have this we have our historical
We need to proceed. Other stakeholders.
That's all I do.
In Georgia, it's a big problem. Georgia. Girls are going out from school after the.
This was the question. Enhancing or recommendation? Enhancing critical thinking, media literacy, particularly in the use of internet and social media, so as to develop resistance to all forms of discrimination and indoctrination. And if we look at what we've written so far, we agree that they are relative to the people who come to some precise parts.
So they go and have a meeting every month with the leaders and with the teachers, and they are actually following all the principles that the schools are going to follow.
Yeah, well, we have that with governing bodies.
Yes. But the trend is to reduce the number of pairs.
Okay, but because it's the opposite in Denmark now. That, and actually, they have there is a new reform now, and you have to evolve the pairings. So, for instance, in 6 weeks of the year, you can evolve the pairings in the class, and they are going to decide the curriculum. So you say, for instance, in my child's school, they give £1,000, the school gives £1,000, and they say, it's up to you to decide what the children are going to do this week.
Okay, you're stating this opinion, but basis on what? Also the ability to disagree peacefully. I mean, if you actually have that, all the, like, the main things that,
With the kindergarten and with the primary school, then it's grow up. So. But you know that from the
Maybe we should just identify the problems.